Today we are talking about displacement, another kind of displacement reaction, that is double displacement reaction. Now in this kind of reaction, what actually happens is the substances, they mutually exchange their positions. So the elements mutually exchange their positions. Better to say the ions mutually exchange their positions to form two new substances. So the ions in two compounds, mutually exchange their positions to form two new substances or two new compounds. We can say two new compounds. Right. We shall just take a look at an illustration to understand this point. Now suppose we have a substance here which is made up of two ions. Okay. And this is reacting with another substance which is also made up of two ions. So both of these are involved in a reaction. And maybe that these two ions are metallic ions, okay, and these two ions are non-metallic ions. Let us call this one A, this one X, this one B, and this one Y. So a compound AX with A as the metal ion and X as the non-metal ion, and another compound BY with B as the metal ion and Y as the non-metal ion, are reacting with each other. So these are the reactants. These are the reactants, and as a result of this reaction, what is happening? We are getting two more products. But how these two substances are reacting to form two new products? They are mutually exchanging their positions. Means that this A and B, their positions will be interchanged. So A will go with Y and B will go with X. So this A, it will go with Y, and this B, it will come over here. This A will come over here. Okay, so these are the products. Right, these are the products of the reaction. So in this manner, when the ions mutually exchange their positions to form two new compounds, we have what is known as a double displacement reaction. If you see your NCERT book, you will find the discussion over here, and there is also an experiment with an equation. It shows the reaction between sodium sulfate and barium chloride. To get barium sulfate and sodium chloride, we'll just take a look at the demonstration of the experiment, and then you'll be able to appreciate it better. So here you have sodium sulfate, okay, this is sodium sulfate and this is barium chloride, and we have prepared solutions of both of these things. This is a solution of barium chloride, this is a solution of sodium sulfate, okay, and we are going to now put these solutions in two different test tubes, because it will be easier to perform the experiments using the test tubes. So we are pouring both the solutions into two test tubes. This is one of the solutions, okay, and the other solution also we will be taking in another test tube like this. Now both the solutions are in two test tubes, and what we are going to do is we are going to mix the two solutions so that they can react. So barium chloride and sodium sulfate both are in two test tubes, and now we are going to make them react with each other, okay. So when you put mix them together, you immediately see that you get a white precipitate over here. This is a precipitate. We'll soon come to the discussion what a precipitate is, but the reaction has been completed, and this precipitate is of barium sulfate. Actually what you are seeing here is barium sulfate, right? So we'll just get back to our NCERT book and just take a look over here. Rather, it's better for us to take this reaction from here and use it in our own place. Okay, we'll be using it here now. Okay, so we have the reaction here. This is the reaction. So the reaction is between sodium sulfate and barium chloride. You can see that sodium, it is now, after the reaction, it is now with the chloride ion, and barium, which was formerly with the chloride ion, is now with the sulfate ion. So they have exchanged their positions. This barium sulfate, you can see this is solid. So this does not dissolve in water, and so it settles down as a precipitate. We shall discuss in a later video in details about what a precipitate is and what such kinds of reactions are called. So at present we are dealing with this double displacement reaction, and this is an example of double displacement reaction. So to summarize the discussion, we have, it is a reaction in which the two ions in two separate compounds, they mutually exchange their positions to form two new products. So we'll be back again in another video where we shall discuss about in details about this kind of reaction, that is precipitation reaction. Thank you.